my special guest is the newest addition to the ROH roster, Adam Page.
Oh, look, I'll do it, but do I have to do it shirtless? Is it necessary?
Well, of course, you're on the Hoopla Club.
Yeah, I have a better idea. You do it shirtless, and I'll have a new hat.
Ooh, you gonna do something about it?
You wanna talk? Yeah. Talk.
I've got it. Trust me, I've got more to say than you, kid.
Bye, Adam Page. Jimmy Jacobs! Now we're talking. Welcome to Hoopla Uncut.
It's a pleasure having you here.
I'm surprised. Somebody thinks it's a pleasure having me around, because here on Ring of Honor tonight, apparently it wasn't a pleasure to have me around. Apparently I wasn't invited. In fact, I wasn't even invited to your show, Hoopla Uncut. I just sort of showed up. That's sort of what I'm doing these days. See, Ring of Honor hasn't exactly been booking me. By Ring of Honor, I mean my old friend, Nigel McGuinness. Hey, the Book of Truth says a lot of stuff, doesn't it?
It sure does.
You tell me what the Book of Truth says about somebody you've known for 10 years who decides to screw you over and not support the job. Tell me what this book says about a company you've been working for 10 years and decides they just want to punish you by not booking you and starve you out. Tell me what the book says about that.
Jimmy Jacobs, my friend, what that sounds to me is a lack of respect. A man that has been here since 2003. Hell, you've done it all, Jimmy.
You're darn right. I've bled for this company. I've fought for this company. I've given my heart for this company. I have more passion than anybody in this locker room, right or wrong. I don't know what you thought about, scum. Maybe you were right, maybe you were wrong, but I did something I believed in.
Yeah.
See, Ring of Honor now, and Nigel McGuinness, who I thought was my friend for 10 years, get that, 10 years?
10 years long.
Is now trying to starve me out, but thanks to the Ring of Honor fans here in Toronto, I did not starve whatsoever, no. I figured out a way to pay my bills thanks to them.
I mean, especially here in Toronto, I think that you should have been in the tournament.
Do you know the guys that I've beaten in the Ring of Honor World Title Tournament? Just in the past few months, guys like B.J. Whitmer and Jay Lethal and Michael Elliott, the number one contender, and Kevin Steve Walls, nobody has beat for the past few years. I pinned him last time I was in Toronto, so it's sort of, it's puzzling, it's ponderous, and you can puzzle till your puzzler is sore, but it doesn't quite make sense, other than the fact that Nigel's holding some sort of personal grudge and wants to punish me. Well, you know what? I don't get punished. So everywhere I'm not invited to, whether it's Hoopla Uncut or a Ring of Honor show, you bet I'll be there. And I'll be there until something gives, until something breaks. See, I've caused a lot of mayhem in this company I own. There's this whole movement about purifying Ring of Honor. See, you know the mayhem I've caused in this company.
I've seen it.
And if they want this place to be pure, you have to deal with me first. See, I'm like Hermes. I ain't gonna leave.
Jimmy Jacobs, thanks for showing up. It's been a pleasure. Oh, that was great, great. Actually, now we can go back to talking what we were talking about earlier. See, all of a sudden, I've been really into this thing called Sleeper Saw. You know what that is? We'll talk about it later. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. We'll see you next time on Hoopla Uncut.